Hey everyone, this is my brief review of the VX Gaming handheld console, which I purchased from a Giant Tiger for 20 bucks as it was on sale. So it's your standard kind of like little mini console with 500-ish built-in games, with a backlit display, your standard four buttons, etc. And yeah, charges via micro USB, and yeah, has a standard. Standard screen, which you'll see here. So upon selection, you have both Chinese and English. We'll select English. I'm just going to turn on the volume. So the volume is just a standard slider, which you'll see here. So these are pretty standard for anyone who's ever owned one of these before. You'll kind of get the intro menu, and then you get your selection of 500 games. Selecting Chinese or English. So we're gonna select English and we'll just go through the game titles. So about 500 titles, as you can see here, a lot of them are kind of cheap knockoffs. So we have, a version of Angry Birds and Super Contra and Jackal, mostly just NES games or imitation NES games. The games that are on here that you'll know, for example, Super Mario Brothers 3 is a good one. I'll start with that. So Super Mario Brothers 3 is actually the Japanese version of Super Mario Brothers 3. So there's a couple pretty big differences in this version versus some of the other versions that you'll see. Specifically that like if you get hit with anything like a shell and you have Tanuki Mario, you will automatically be turned from large to small. So difficulty's a little bit harder. The other piece as well that you'll see is, in this version, none of the text obviously is in English. So overall, controls are pretty standard. Nothing amazing, nothing terrible. It works and plays like it should. I've only got one hand here, so we're gonna see the most deadly Goomba in the history of Mario games, who's probably killed more characters, more Mario than anyone else. So yeah, that's basically it. Overall, the console works pretty well. Let's just go back and I'll show you the game selection. The one thing I do find is that the overall screen on this is not very good. I've seen comparable models with a much better screen. So this is the game selection. I'll try and zoom in so you guys can see what they are. Sorry, trying to get all these in here. And you can pause the video if you need to see. The Tetris is the 10-gen Tetris. And yeah, there's some definite like knockoffs here. You'll see like several different versions of Mario, which are kind of all just reskins of other games. And a lot of classic ones, any of you that have bought consoles like this before are familiar with things like, Police Dog Lassie and things like that. Actually, I'm not even sure. UFO Racer's on here for sure. So quite a few games, and again, about 4 hour battery life, so it's got 4 hours of play time, and I'm sure you'll find something in here that you might enjoy. For 20 bucks, it's not a terrible console to pick up. I'll do a review shortly of kind of one of the other consoles that I have, that you guys will see. And sorry, just zooming in on the game again. So you guys can see all these. Overall, the controls are okay. Like I said, the screen isn't great. It's pretty small, and the lighting on it, unless you're looking at it directly, doesn't look amazing. But again, I mean, it's a $20 console. It does come with a bonus controller you'll see in the picture there, which connects via micro USB. So you can use that as well. And yeah, that's a Zippy Race. So in the actual box, which I'll open up here, this is generally what it comes with. So yeah, fun unboxing this whole thing. So obviously the console's in the top part. The controller's pretty small. You can see the size of my hands compared to the unit. Yeah, that's my thumb. So, and it does come with the, you know, the video and audio out. So yeah, again, you get your, like your four buttons, your start and your select, and it, connects again to the top of the console. Kind of interesting that it does also use micro USB, to connect the console. So you can't obviously charge it and play it at the same time, and comes with a micro USB cable as well. So the box, yeah, just advertises the 300 games. It does come in with a built-in rechargeable battery, which is in the back here. So you can see the built-in rechargeable battery and the backfiring speakers, which are kind of annoying because realistically when you're playing the game, you'll put your hand over it. And yeah, at that point you can't hear a certain speaker. I can't really confirm whether it's stereo or not. So yeah, here's I'll show you some gameplay again as best as I can. Let's choose try and use Jackal or something. So there's Jackal, nice Konami classic. The screen doesn't look terrible in this video. But as you can see, I put it down, can't hear it. Yeah, my apologies, I'm doing this one-handed. I don't really have a camera set up, so. Let's get out of here. I'm also looking at this through my phone, so don't criticize, but. So anyways, that's what you can hear what it sounds like. I'm getting shot at. But yeah, it runs well. Some screen tearing and stuff that you'll see, pretty standard of these units. I mean, again, for $20, it's not terrible, but I have another better version that I'll show you guys as well in a bit, but I figured I'd put this up. Again, I won't be keeping this. I bought it from Giant Tiger, which actually has a great return policy, so you can return anything to Giant Tiger basically at any point, as long as you keep the receipt. So you can try things out. If you don't like them, don't want to keep them, you don't have to, so... yeah, so that's it. That's my review. Let me know if you have any questions or concerns in the comments, and we'll chat with you later.